Hey everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can run AdguardHome in the cloud. The one major advantage of this setup would be your AdguardHome won't remain limited to your home setup only. You could run your personal DNS resolver when you are on your cellular network or on your laptop when you are out using public Wi-Fi. For this setup, you are going to need an access to a cloud service provider, a VM where there is no existing web server running, and lastly, a domain. With that being said, let's start with the actual setup guide. Okay, so here we are. First of all, let's install AdguardHome. I have opened the AdguardHome's GitHub page, and you just have to copy this command and paste it in your VM. Okay, our AdguardHome has been installed. As you can see, the AdguardHome is currently running on the local server. It is not running on the public IP addresses. We can modify the AdguardHome's config file and open firewall ports and so on and on. But there is a easier way of accessing AdguardHome's web interface, okay, with SSH tunneling. Okay, for that, I'm using mobile extreme, okay. I would recommend that you use try giving mobile extreme a chance. It is a good piece of software, okay. I'll have to type this here. And the remote port is 3000. The server is this, SSH login, and is Ubuntu, port is 22. Save. And I'll have to import the key. Okay, now we have forwarded 3000 port to the destination server. Now we will be able to access the AdguardHome setup page. Okay. You don't have to make much changes here, okay, since we are not going to use a plain DNS. You can choose whatever port you like. It really doesn't matter for the plain DNS. Click next for admin panel. I'm just using a simple password, but make sure, absolutely make sure that you use a very strong password here, okay. The dashboard won't open anymore because it is running on port 80 now, but we can't access that port because it is because the port 80 isn't open. So we are going to change the port here. Okay. Now we are going to use port 80. Every other setting would remain the same. Let's start. Okay. 3000. And we can now log in, okay? Okay, so we have our AdGuard running now. Now come to settings and encryption settings, okay? Before enabling anything, we are going to add a record, okay, in our DNS records of the domain. I would recommend that you open a random or like something website and generate a random string for a subdomain because we are going to use a subdomain for our AdguardHome, okay? Choose lowercase strings. Length would 15 would be suffice, okay. 15, you can even go as far as I believe 20, even more. Let's get a string. Okay, we have our string. Now open your DNS provider's dashboard, add a record. Since I am using Cloudflare, okay, don't proxy the DNS, okay. You only need plain DNS. Since we are not going to publicly state this subdomain anywhere, okay. So click save. Okay, now we have our a record pointing to the IP address of the VM. The next part is getting, I believe, yes, installing an Acme client. Since AdguardHome is going to take over the port 443, we can't run a web server for fetching our Let's Encrypt or Zero SSL certificate. So we are going to need a client which supports verifying our domain ownership with DNS. Okay, I'm using acme.sh and it works perfectly for my setup, but your mileage may vary. But acme.sh has a very extensive support of multiple DNS providers, so it is very likely that your setup would be covered here. Okay, copy this command. I'll have the link in the video's description for the repository. Okay, it has copied some gibberish. Let me remove that. Make sure, my dear people, that you use a actual email address here, okay? Don't use a default one, and otherwise it won't work. No, bash aliases are not updated, so let me exit it one time and restart this. Now let's try again. Okay, now it is working. Now coming to the next setup, acme.sh by default uses zero SSL for our setup. It is fine. It is just my personal preference to use Let's Encrypt, but you can use zero SSL as well. Next, acme.sh is going to need the API keys of your DNS provider to access your DNS record and add a text record for verification purposes. Acme.sh has a guide for plenty of DNS providers. Okay, let me show you. And you can check them here and add your DNS provider's API's keys. Then afterwards, when you have all three tokens for Cloudflare or your DNS provider, go back to your shell, SSH, and now when we have exported our DNS API keys, now let's move to the next step. Okay, my dear people, no matter what happened, you are going to need a wildcard records, okay? Because let me show you something. If you did not go for a wildcard record, okay, anybody who can access your domain, okay, if you are using a pub domain for a website hosting, and so anybody could search this and they can have the list of every certificate you have issued so far. Okay, so please get a wildcard certificate. No matter what happens, you are going to need a wildcard certificate. If you are already running a setup like this and you don't know this, I don't know how to explain this here, but you are going to need a wildcard certificate. As you can see, I have already issued multiple wildcard certificates and I can't issue because Let's Encrypt have a rate limiting. Okay, so I'm going to issue a specific certificate for my domain, but please, no matter what happens, issue a wildcard certificate, and your command is going to be like something like this. For this, I am just using this for a demo only. Don't you issue a certificate for your specific subdomain. Okay, in my case my subdomain was okay, we have our certificate. let's encrypt only issues a certificate for 3 months only, and acme.sh installs a Chrome tab, so it would automatically update your certificate when they would need upgrading. I think it upgrades at the start of every third month or so. Anyway, so now we have our certificates. Okay, you have to copy this full chain cert. Copy this. Go to your AdGuard home, click on enable encryption, and paste the certificate path here. Okay, for key, this is the key. Since our domain is this, I can just copy this from here and paste it here. Okay, we have pasted the subdomain. Now click on save configuration. And our configuration has been saved. Okay, so now let's see if we can access our AdGuardHome's web page from the URL. Okay, we can access it. Don't search this full domain anywhere, okay, on Google or any other search engine. Okay, because if anybody got access to this subdomain, they can just confirm if you are running DOH on your setup or not. See, it has already said that it is a bad request, but when we would send a write request, it would work. Let me show you. Okay, it's zero. Let me send a proper DNS over HTTPS request. Okay, it has worked. Yes, it has worked. Okay, so don't paste this URL any search engine, okay? I was able to access this DNS query page because I already had the ports open, but for you are going to add 3 ports. First is for DNS over HTTPS. So what would you do is copy the command and paste it. Next is for DNS over TLS. Next is for DNS over QUIC, which is a new protocol. Okay, now you would need to install iptables-persistent. So if you have ever rebooted your VM, your iptables would stay persistent. Okay, you would install iptables-persistent with apt. Okay, then you would copy this command and paste it. Okay, now your IP tables would become persistent. Okay, my dear people, you are actually done here. Okay, you can now customize your AdGuard home however you like. In the end, acme.sh says that it says that the acme.sh will save your account ID or account ID, say your DNS APIs in the account.conf, but it does not do that actually. I don't know what wrong I am doing in my from my end, but it does not do that. Let me show you. See, it does not have lines for your API keys. In my setup, all I had to do was copy the existing API keys, okay, with their variable names, and remove export. And change the quotation mark to single just to be on the safe side. Okay. And that's it. I was done from my end. For you, the setup would mostly be the same. Okay. Let me just save it. And from now, you can just use your setup, customize your AdGuard home however you like, and you have your AdGuard home running in the cloud. I think this is it for this video. Okay, my dear people, I have the hopes to see you in the next one. Bye, everyone.